We're back at the hotel 7 days after the initial baiting. We did return after two just to make sure that everything was suitable and sufficient, but there was no sign of any rat activity. The hotel reported some sightings to the front of the property a day or so after the initial baiting, but there's nothing since. Hopefully this is a clear sign of the stop feed technology, where the rats aren't moving around the property looking for food opportunities. We'll now complete another survey of the site, checking our baiting points and our monitoring stations. We'll start at the rear of the property, or our location number three, and already the signs are looking very good. If we zoom in on the void in between the bins and the storage area, looks like we've got some good activity already.
We can immediately see exactly what we hope to find. A collection of wrappers still on the wire with no bait remaining. Perfect. This is very exciting, as it's a complete take, especially in an area where there is an alternate food source available on the floor. Let's remove these old wrappers and rebait with fresh cilantro. Again, we will apply 7 blocks in accordance with the product label. The covered and protected sheet has worked well to retain the natural light within this space and has not significantly changed the natural environment. The bait in the station to the side of the kitchen door have not been eaten, and the sand also confirms that rats haven't been active through the box. As we look at the area around the burrows, leaves are starting to build up and the area generally looks less active. We're also going to add an additional run-through station to the front of the property. Initially, I didn't want to have baiting stations visible to the guests of the hotel, especially without knowing the full scale of the activity. We will use a run-through covered and protected station. This is less obvious to the guests that this is a rat baiting station. However, it still has all the necessary external awareness information as required by the product label. And with the excess wire, it can be secured in position. The primary area of concern from the hotel's point of view was the activity to the front of the property. There has been no consumption from this station and no footprints through the sand. So this confirms the lack of activity to the side of the property and that it is mainly active within the bin store and the side corner bushes. This is a real progress from the hotel's point of view.
As we conclude our second treatment, it's been a very positive follow-up. Initially, we placed 49 blocks around the property. Today, we replaced 12 and added 7 more, just to make sure along the front of the property. The real positive is that no rats have been seen in and around the building over the last couple of days. We've asked the site to tidy up, particularly in the bin area, just to remove food opportunity and make the site less attractive. I don't believe this will have any impact on the treatment process because I think we've already found the main pocket of activity and a large amount of bait has already been eaten. We'll leave it for another 7 days. We'll just come back and check and make sure that it's a positive outcome, that no more bait take has been made, and more importantly, no more footprints in our monitoring locations. It just remains to complete our treatment report and make sure we document all of our actions and activities for today. See you next week.
BASF. We create chemistry.